Devanani, and today I am here to tell you about Pluto. You may be wonder that why I select this topic, because it is a by a particular reason is, you know, we are humans. Let's take example. You and your 5 friends make a plan to go on party, okay? You 6 make a plan, but on the party day only 5 came with you. When 6 out of 5 you came, so you know what, all 5 will think about that 6th one. Why he's not with us? If he were, then how we will enjoy that, you know, that who's not present with us now, we only think about that, not who's been present with us. So now Pluto is not present with us, that's why I select this topic to tell about it. So before telling the mysterious thing about the Pluto, I would like to tell you some information about the Pluto, because you may be not, you don't know about Pluto. So next. Yeah. First of all, Pluto was a planet which was discovered by an American astronomer, Clary Tombaugh, in 1830 or 1830. It was discovered. It was considered as a planet before 2006, and it was 9th planet of our solar system because it was located after Neptune. In our solar system, Neptune is the 8th planet, so it was located after that. That's why we consider it as 9th planet. And it was too small in size. It was same in size of our moon. Moon is small compared to other planets. Yeah. As the Pluto is round in shape, its diameter is approximately 2,374 kilometers, whereas the diameter of Earth is 12,700, which is 6 times greater than Earth, greater than Pluto. Pluto is too small. And Pluto's mass is 1.309 × 10⁻², whereas the mass of Earth is 5.74 × 10⁻², which is 2 greater than Pluto. And Pluto is too cold planet. Its temperature is −229°C, whereas the coldest temperature on our Earth is Antarctica's temperature. Antarctica is the coldest continent on our Earth. Its temperature is −57° only. There, no people can live. Only people go there for room or as a tourist place, but there we cannot live because it is too cold. But from that, Pluto is too cold. It is −229°. And as it is too cold, it is mostly made up of ice. All the surface, outer surface is totally made up of ice of Pluto, but the internal part of Pluto contains some small rock. As our Earth contains crust or core inside the Earth, that's like Pluto contains rock inside, rocky core inside its internal surface. Outside is totally made up of rock, ice. Next, yeah. As the Pluto is too far, it was away from Neptune. Now, it is its distance from Sun is 4.4 billion kilometers, whereas the distance of Earth from Sun is 149.6 billion kilometers. So, it is too far away from our Earth. We can assume that is a billion and it's a million. And it takes 6.4 Earth days to complete one rotation. It is too slow planet. It takes 6.4, whereas our Earth completes this in one day. 6.4 Earth days means 6 days, 9 hours and 36 minutes. And as it is too far away from our solar system, its orbit is too large compared to Earth. It takes 248 Earth years to complete one orbit around the Sun, whereas Earth completed 1 year. But Pluto hasn't completed one orbit around the Sun because it was discovered in 1930, and till now only 87 years are done. 161 years are remaining to complete its one orbit. But the sad thing is, Pluto, now we don't consider Pluto as a planet. It was considered till 2006. So enough, you know that why don't we consider Pluto as a planet? Does it move from our solar system? You may think that it has moved from our solar system, or it has considered as moon of Neptune or natural satellite? No. Pluto is at the same place where it was before. It doesn't move from our solar system. A planet cannot move. Next. The changes is in the rules. The rules by International Astronomical Union. They have changed their official rules. Now, 2006, this is the committee of international astronomers where all the planets and discoveries of universe we know as NASA is, now known as NASA. This committee is like that. And this committee has now officially made new rules. Now the rules are: a planet must be round, a planet must orbit the Sun, a planet must clear the objects nearby. Which means a planet should be round in shape, it should have its own orbit around the Sun, and it should attract the objects nearby it. Which means to pull center off. It means if any object comes in the area of that planet, now that should attract towards it. But the Pluto follow only first rules. It is round in shape, it has its own orbit, but it does not follow the third rule, which is to attract objects nearby. So, now the question arises that, what should be called Pluto now? Not a planet, a moon, or a satellite? No. Now planet is considered as a dark planet. Now what does the dark planet mean? Dark planet is a planetary massive object, which means, which is neither a planet nor a moon, which is not a moon but not a satellite. It is a planet which follows only first two rules of IAU. That planet is considered as dark planet. Why we consider it dark planet? Because dark means temporary. That can be permanent. If it started following the third rule, nah, then Pluto will consider it as our real planet, as other planets consider. So it only followed till now two rules, so we consider it as dark planet. Now maybe you think that only there is one dark planet in our solar system? No. There are total 5 dark planets in our solar system. They are named as Aries, Pluto, Oima, Magnet, Ceres. These all are planets which only follow 2 rules of IAU. That's why we consider them as dark planets. But if any of them started following the third rule, then that planet will be considered as the real planet of our solar system. They all are too small in size, and from them the first 4, Aries, Pluto, Oima, Magnet, they all are located after Neptune, beyond Neptune. And Ceres is a planet, is a dark planet which is located between Mars and Jupiter in our solar system. Next. As they all are too small in size, they just look like this, and the radius of Ceres is 945 km, radius of Magnet, diameter of this is 945, Magnet is 1434, Oima's diameter is 1690, and Ceres' diameter is 2386, Pluto's diameter is 2372. From them, Ceres is the biggest dwarf planet, but it is small from real planets. So we consider them as dwarf planets because they follow only two rules. So now our solar system doesn't have 8 planets. If anyone asks from you, then you say to them that our solar system has 8 planets. No, our solar system has 8 real planets and 5 dwarf planets. You all say only that 8 planets, which is incomplete, because there are 5 dwarf planets and they can be real if they started following the third rule. And as the technology increases, we can get more dwarf planets and real planets in our solar system, because we don't know that till now we haven't discovered a full galaxy too. So we cannot say that our solar system only have this. It can be increased as our technology goes on increasing. Next. Now our solar system just looks like this. First Sun, which is star, then Mercury, smallest planet, then Venus, then Earth, but Mars, Ceres, which is between Mars and Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto, Oima, Magnet, and the last is Ceres. This is our solar system, which looks like now. And so you may be thinking that there is moon. Why don't we consider moon as the planet? Anyone you know that? It's not the Pluto's topic, but moon also is round in shape. Now it also attracts the object. Then why don't we consider it as a planet? Because it has an orbit not around the Sun, it has orbit around the Earth. And if any object has orbit around the planet, then we consider that object has moon, as the Jupiter has 17 moons, because they have 17 objects which have orbit around them, not around the Sun but around that planet, that we considered as our moon. So thank you for cooperating. Any queries?